Well, hey there everyone, welcome to another video. Great to have you join me as always. Today we're going to talk about some fragrances and perfumes. I don't talk about the subject as often as I probably should because I have some great things to share with you today. I have four different fragrances. I've got three kind of newer ones and then one that's an oldie but a goodie. However, it's new to me since I've only tried it out about 2 months ago. I've got some notes here in front of me. We are, again, as always, fighting some interesting cloud formations. So I'm gonna try my best to keep the lighting consistent, but we'll just roll with it and see what we get. You know, I think the new year is a great time to try out a new perfume or fragrance because it's that boundary line about doing something new. And if you are or have been doing something new or, you know, wanting to embrace a change, fragrance is a great way to do that. For me, I always try to, you know, in January or even like late December, I'll try to decide on, you know, a perfume to wear for the year. Obviously, I have my signature one. I talked about it in last week's live stream when I was here on YouTube doing a live stream with some of you guys, which is really fun. So thanks for joining me, those of you who are watching this and who did join me last week. So yeah, it's a great time to just embrace a new feel, a new persona, or maybe just to get yourself a bit more confident about the person that you want to be and, you know, the goals that you're working towards. So this, I think, is really going to be my most worn new fragrance of the year. I've already decided because I love it so much. This is the Philosophy Amazing Grace. And while this is not new, it's new to me and it's my first time experiencing it. Those of you who are collectors probably already know and perhaps love this one. It's a very popular scent from Philosophy. And if you think about their brand, they're really about that soft, approachable, you know, non-offensive, kind of everybody-friendly scent. While this is not the most exciting fragrance, at least not of the bunch I've got to show you anyways, I think this is an incredibly versatile and approachable fragrance. For me, this says soft, pretty, inviting. It's very office appropriate if you are allowed to wear some soft fragrances in your workspace. This will also be great for a teen or someone who's just starting out with a fragrance, their first one, and they don't want to go too heavy, too strong. I think this is not only more affordable out of the bunch, but also just so nice. It doesn't change on me throughout the day, and it's got a good, you know, number of hours that it goes through, and I can smell it even by, I would say, the fourth or fifth hour. I can still sometimes get a whiff of it on myself or on my clothes. So it's a scent that makes you feel good. I think that's how I would put it. In terms of notes, it has bergamot, which is a bit of a citrus kick. It's got, I think it's mugget or mugget blossoms, a type of a soft floral. It's also got a base of musk, but this is not a super heavy musk. This just kind of warms up the fragrance and gives it something to, you know, to ground it and just make it a bit fuller. So very, very lovely one. I've been wearing this most frequently out of the whole bunch. But the rest of them I've got for you, the next three, are all newer fragrances. And I think the trend for perfumes, you know, within the last year and definitely going to 2017 still, it's all about quite sweet scents. Everybody's doing sugar, but they're doing sugar in their own way. So I want to first start off with Coach. This is their new Eau de Parfume. And it is a very interesting packaging. I wasn't expecting this when I opened the box. It's got a pebble, like a rounded off square type of shape. It feels really nice in the hand, actually. It holds and feels nice. It's got that little tag on it that says Coach with all of their bags and other products as well. This is part of their signature icon. And it's just a spray format. This is, I would say, preppy, young, carefree. Again, I think quite a versatile scent for a large demographic, you know, whether you're younger or you're older, but this is certainly more of a lifestyle scent. I think this is for someone who has that more preppy aesthetic. And of course, if you like raspberry leaves, if you like Turkish rose and suede musk, this is also all rolled into this perfume from Coach. It does come off a little bit strong at first, but it fades really quickly and settles nicely, I think, on the skin. So this is one from Coach. Then I also have one. Let's talk about this, because he's having a hard moment right now, and you know, I really feel for him, especially because Michael Buble is a local. If you don't know, he comes from around these parts where I live, and this is his new fragrance launch. Now I know what you're thinking, celebrity fragrances, oh no, run for the hills. But while this is not my personal everyday style, I do think there's some merits to it. It is totally different than, like, I would say 95% of celebrity fragrances I've tried, and you know, you've all tried those when you're in the drugstore even. This is a higher end celebrity fragrance. I guess, would you call him a celebrity? I suppose so. I think in terms of his career choice, it makes him a celebrity, but he always seems to be a really kind of down to earth type of guy. So Michael Buble, by invitation, very retro vintage inspired packaging. This is actually just a kind of a metal frame, and this is empty here, so the perfume bottle essentially is suspended within this metal frame. It is a spray format, but it does have that little, you know, touch of that atomizer from the bygone era. So this is, as Michael's music, rather glamorous. It's got a little bit of that jazzy, glamorous feel to it. And the notes in here, I've got it written down, is complex. We've got red fruit, bergamot, again, I really adore bergamot, lily of the valley, as well as wild jasmine, peony, musk, sandalwood as well, and a touch of vanilla. So this is glamorous, it's warm, it's also very confident. Michael described this as, you know, if he was stuck in an elevator with someone, you know, he referred to it as a woman, he wouldn't mind being stuck in an elevator with her if she smelled like this. So this, while not being my everyday fragrance, I think it would be a nice one for a night out, something for special occasions, or if all the adjectives I use really describe you on an everyday basis, then maybe this could be your everyday scent as well. This, I think they categorized it as a floral oriental, so that gives you a clue about by invitation from Michael Buble. Moving on, the third and last one we're going to talk about is the My Burberry Black. And the whole concept of this one is to really make it an individual fragrance, which I've mentioned before, if you happen to buy this online, Burberry offers a free monogramming of your initials on the bottom. So when I got mine from the PR package, it actually has my initials on it engraved into the bottle. I thought that was a really smart touch to promote the perfume, the whole aesthetic around it, and also smart marketing as well. So My Burberry Black really follows on the trend of sweetness. I mean, by invitation from Michael Buble is sweet, but this is like sweet, really sweet. However, it's a different type of sweetness than, say, Sugar Aqualina. I think that's the one, that's the classic one I think of when people tell me, you know, sugary fragrances. However, this is a more grown-up sweet scent. It's certainly a very confident scent. It's a mysterious scent, but with a bit of sweetness to it, certainly for, I think, someone a bit older and more mature. So not for the teenage audience, shall I say. It's not that type of sugariness. It's got a number of things. It's got jasmine, it's got peach nectar, candied rose, amber, and patchouli in it. So there's a depth and richness to the sugar as well. And I would say the whole kind of overall vibe of it, again, very Burberry with the touch of the, I think the fabric is called gerberdine ribbon. It's the classic trench coat fabric that they use for their iconic trench coat. It's got the turquoise shell cap, oversized cap, and it sits really prettily on your vanity, I gotta say. For me, this is probably a much stronger scent. And not something I would wear every single day. However, in the winter season, because I got this a little while ago, I have been wearing it more. Going into spring and summer, I probably reserve this for days when I'm feeling it, or for a night out or a night event. However, if you do like kind of richer, sweeter scents, this might be the one for you. For me, favorite out of the bunch, Amazing Grace. This will probably be my second runner-up though, as being a favorite. I've talked about it quite a bit on my blog, but four fragrances, all very different, and all, you know, they've got their own unique twist to the sweet, which I think is, again, the trend going into 2017. If you have a favorite fragrance, or if any of these are already your favorites, leave me a comment down below and let me know. I love to hear what you've been discovering this year in the realm of perfume. I believe I'm going to a perfume launch next week, so that's again something new. I'm interested to see what everybody is putting out there, but these four on rotation right now. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you next time very soon. Take care. Bye.